to do another yin practice with you today. Today's practice is a yin practice without props. So normally in my practices that I teach, I like to use lots of props. The only prop we'll use today is the wall. So if you don't have anything at home, this is a perfect practice for you. So for those of you that are new to yin, it is all about getting into the joints, the ligaments, and the connective tissue of your body through stillness. And we use props generally to build up support so that we can effectively soften into those spaces. We will use the wall as a prop today to give us a little bit of support in certain poses, but a lot of the time we'll also be using the floor. So make sure you have some wall space nearby, and I'll give you a few moments to get into that space while I give you a little extra spiel. So in yin, there should not be any pain. If there's pain, you need to back out, readjust, find a space that works for you, and then possibly come back into the pose. If there is discomfort, try to sit with it. Try not to fidget and wiggle and move. Ultimately, if you have to move, you have to move, but do try to sit with it. So, you are the boss of your body. If something doesn't feel right, don't continue. If there's pain, back out, adjust, and settle in. And if there's discomfort, try to roll with it for a moment. So hopefully you're near your wall now, and let's get to it. So we'll start off in a cozy seat. This is cozy for me. It doesn't have to be cozy for you. Just find a seat that resonates with you. Feel your hips root down. Feel your spine lengthen up from your pelvis. Stack your throat over your hips, and if it's comfortable, close your eyes. Relax your jaw. Soften your face and allow your body and your mind to settle in. And we'll take three deep breaths here. In through your nose, out through your mouth. And again through your nose, and out. Once more in, and release. Scan your body. Notice any sensations, any spaces of tension, and anything else that draws your attention. Know that we're not judging anything that we find. We're just looking for awareness to best serve your body today. Notice where your mind is. If it begins to wander at any moment, don't get frustrated. Just come back to this space. Back to your body, and back to your breath. And notice your breath. Is it shallow, rapid, or ragged? Or could you take your breath a little deeper? And finally, shift your awareness to an intention. Something you'd like to manifest through the practice, or recognize the reason why you made it to your mat today. If you don't have an intention for yourself, my intention for this practice will be compassion. So not only finding compassion with your body and all of its abilities and its limitations, finding compassion in the poses, and allowing yourself to be where you are rather than where you think you should be. But also finding compassion with your mind, even in stressful moments. Find compassion. Give yourself just 2% more compassion. And breathing in a compassionate way, to allow your body and your mind to soften down. So whether you've created your own intention or accepted mine, with your next three exhales, send it out onto your mat and out into the space that you're in. one more deep breath for yourself. And let it go. And softly open your eyes. And we'll move up to the wall. So there's a fancy little trick to get to the wall in a way that you're not having to struggle to scoot up to it. So you'll get up close to the wall. And you'll place the soles of your feet against the wall. And then you'll place your booty up against the wall. So it's like I'm seated, but on the wall. And then I'll bring my bottom side shoulder down. So I'm laying on my right side right now. I'll bring my right shoulder down. And then just cartwheel my legs up. And for some of you, this is going to be really close to the wall. You can always scoot your hips further away from the wall. It's a lot easier to scoot back than it is to scoot up to it. So you can scoot back to give yourself a little bit of space if you need. And our first position is just going to be a butterfly. So you can bring the soles of your feet together and let your knees fall off to the sides. Or you can also take a dragonfly, which is just your legs out wide. So I want you to choose one of those two that resonates with your body. And then once you find your space, allow yourself to settle in. And in my yin classes that I teach, I like you to focus in on the sensations of your body and focus in on your breath. So I won't be talking a whole lot. I want you to really dive into your own practice. And remember, we're not trying to force ourselves deep into spaces. We're allowing our bodies to relax and melt into these spaces. And the nice part about being here is that we can focus on our bellies rising and falling with our breath. Notice where your mind is. If it begins to wander, know that that's okay. Just come back to your body and your breath.
If your body's inviting you a little deeper, and whatever deeper is for you, now's a good time to go there. Otherwise, stay right where you are. Take three cleansing breaths to close out this pose. After your third breath, bend your knees and bring them together and find whatever movement your body needs. And from here, we'll move into our next position, which is going to be a swan, but again, on the wall. So I recommend that you scoot your butt just a little bit further away from the wall. Otherwise, it will be very intense, very fast. So generally, about a 90 degree angle in the legs is a good amount of space. You can always scoot in. So from here, lift your right leg up towards the sky. And cross your right ankle across your left knee. You can give your right knee some support with your right hand, but don't push yourself. Just allow yourself to be here. If this is a lot of sensation, if it feels like it's a bit much for your body, scoot your hips further away from the wall. If you want a little bit more intensity, scoot your hips closer to the wall. And we're not pushing our legs anywhere. We're just finding a space that works well and softening into that space. And we'll breathe. we'll take our three cleansing breaths to close out this pose. After your third breath, extend your right leg up and release it down. And find whatever movement suits your body best. And when you've accomplished what your body needs, we'll take the other side. So right foot is planted against the wall, left foot rises up towards the sky, and then cross your left knee, or cross your left ankle across your right knee. And again, you can find support for your left knee without pushing it. If this side feels a little intense, scoot your hips away from the wall. If you want a little bit more intensity, scoot your hips closer to the wall. We'll take three cleansing breaths to close out this pose. after your third breath, extend your left leg up and release it. And find whatever movement your body needs. And when you've accomplished what your body needs, roll over onto your belly,
but stay near the wall. We'll take Sphinx, but we'll use the wall as a little bit of support as well. So, as you can see, my knees are bent, my knees are touching the wall, and my feet are up against the wall as well. And for our Sphinx, I'll give you two options. So option one is to take your fingertips out from your elbows and have your shoulders stacked above your elbows. Another option is to bring your hands to touch your elbows for a little bit more support. So this feels like a little bit more easeful Sphinx. So find which one works for you. And you can choose to stay upright just like this, or you can let your heart sink down and let your head sink down as well. And we'll just breathe here. And you can choose to stay here for another moment, or if you want to get a little bit more spacious in your back, we'll take more of a seal. So you'll take your arms just a little wider than your shoulders and lift yourself up. Now this is a really deep back bend, so don't feel obligated to do it. Don't feel obligated to stay here for more than a moment if it doesn't feel right for your body. This is a really deep space to be in. Wherever you choose to be, we'll take our three cleansing breaths. After your third breath, softly lower down and scoot off the wall. And you can find whatever movement your body needs. And from here, we'll move into a child's pose. So if you need a little bit of support, you can grab a blanket. It's not a requirement. We're just taking a regular child's pose. I like to take my knees wide so I have space for my abundance so I can breathe. So my knees are wide. My big toes touch, my hips are over my heels,
And I'll walk my hands forward and rest my forehead down. If at any moment this becomes a bit much for your shoulders, you can always take your hands and tuck them between your knees towards your feet and take one cheek to the mat. This is actually a really cozy position. So if you want to leave your shoulders out and focus more on softening through your back, this is a really nice space to go to. Notice where your mind is. Focus in on your breath. We'll take our three cleansing breaths to close out of this pose. After your third breath, press into your hands, lift up, and find whatever movement your body needs. And then when you're ready, curl over onto your back. And we'll take a full body stretch here. And reach your arms out, reach your legs out. And take your arms the width of your mat, and take your feet the width of your mat as well. So you're in a big X shape. And you'll take your right foot over to the left side of your mat so that both your feet are on the left side, and cross your left ankle on top of your right. It's not necessarily to make it a more intense sensation, it's more about anchoring it down. And then take your right hand over to the left. You can walk your shoulders and your head over to the left as well. So you're shaped like a banana. We're creating space along your right side body. And we'll just breathe here. Feel the space you're breathing into your right side ribs. Feel your belly rise and fall with your breath. We'll take our three cleansing breaths to close out this pose. After your third breath, bring your arms and legs back to center. Find whatever movement your body needs. accomplish what your body needs, we'll come back into that full body stretch, turning our bodies into that big X shape. This time you'll take your left foot over to the right side of your mat and cross your right foot over top. And then take your left hand over to the right. You can lock your shoulders and your head with it. So again, you're shaped like a banana. This time creating space along your left side body. And allow your body to soften just 2% more. We'll take our three cleansing breaths to close out this pose. Your third breath, come back to center, find whatever movement your body needs, then bring your arms out to a T shape, straight out from your shoulders, palms facing up, and take both knees up and over towards your left elbow. Again, if there's space between your knees or the floor, you can always use a blanket. It's not required, but Allow yourself to be compassionate and receive support when you need it. Take our three cleansing breaths here. After your third breath, bring your knees through center and over to the right side of your mat. Again, if you need support, give yourself support. Remember to keep your palms facing up. Allow your shoulders to stay open and soft. take our three cleansing breaths here. After your third breath, come back to center and find whatever movement your body needs. And from here, we'll move into our Shavasana, our final resting pose. So the nice part about this Shavasana is you can do a Shavasana on the floor, or if you'd like, you can do a legs up the wall, since we're close to the wall. So that's what I'm going to choose to do. So if your arms are down by your sides, let your palms face up. Lift your chest and tuck your shoulder blades in towards your spine so they lay flat on the floor. If your feet are on the floor, take your legs wide and let your feet fall wherever they choose to land. Tuck your chin in towards your chest just slightly so your neck is nice and long and spacious. Feel all the points of contact between your body and the floor. Each exhale, feel your body relax down a little more. And as you feel your body soften down, feel the earth rise up to support you, to carry you. Allow yourself that support. Allow your body to soften into it just a little more. Allow your body to be still, and the only movement be your breath. And in this moment, you don't have to control your breath. Allow your body to breathe for you. And allow yourself to witness your breath rather than controlling it. Enjoy this moment. It is for you. as we begin to close out of this Shavasana, bring your awareness to your breath. Take your breath a little deeper for just another moment. Feel the softness and ease throughout your body. Turn the corners of your lips upwards. Graze your thumbs across each of your fingertips. And roll your wrists. Spread your toes. And roll your ankles. Maybe rock your head side to side. And if it feels right, take a full body stretch. You can choose to stay as you are for another moment, or if you'd like, gently roll to your left side. You can use your arm as a little pillow and just take a moment to soak up this last little bit of stillness. And when it feels best to you, softly, slowly, gently make your way up to a comfortable seated position with your hands at your heart center. Let's take one more deep breath together, in and out. Bow to yourself. Send yourself some gratitude for making it to the mat today. And send some love and compassion to your very strong, very capable, very beautiful body. Thank you for making your way onto your mat today. Thank you for sharing your practice with me and allowing me to share mine with you via this video. The light in me loves the light in each of you. Namaste. So I hope you're all soft and smushy and happy. I hope you have a magical rest of your day, and hopefully I'll see you again soon.